Hello and welcome to another techandmusiced.com video. And today I am extremely excited to show you a couple of new products from CME, the XKey Air, and something called the WIDI Bud. So let's talk about the XKey Air first. It is a portable Bluetooth MIDI keyboard controller that comes in 25 or 37 keys. And the price of the 25 is $199. The price of the 37 is $299. And it basically is a keyboard with very low travel, but keys that press, with a wonderful aluminum top, plastic back, an LED indicator, power button, and then some of your other standard buttons such as octave plus, octave minus, I believe it says regulation, pitch bend up, pitch bend down, and sustain. So in a very, very small package. And it works well, and I'll show you that in just a moment. But what I really first want to show you is two things that I thought was really excellent. First of all, it's an unboxing experience. This is the box it comes in. That's very much like an Apple product. High quality box, comes packaged nicely. It's something that looks like it should come from the Apple store. Now also, it comes with its own micro USB cable, which is not a big deal, but there's two things that I like about it. First of all, it comes with a little label on, and I wish this was actually a little bit more durable material, because I have gone to labeling a lot of my cables with a label maker, particularly if I want to keep that cable with the device it came with, or it has a special cable. It helps me identify those in our large cable drawer at home. Also, on the top of the USB cable, where it plugs into the computer, it actually says on the top, CME, if the camera can focus on that. So that's a nice way to know that that's the cable that came with your device. Now granted, will any USB, micro USB cable work? Absolutely. So again, that might be a moot point, but it's just another part of the niceness of what you're getting for the price. So I like that boxing. And just in comparison, you know, here is the box that one of our little iPad minis came in from Apple. And anybody that owns an Apple product knows that part of the joy of buying a product is that unboxing experience. So again, the boxing is high retail and would fit perfectly in an Apple store. Now, as for how it actually works, let me show you. So I've got my iPad running here, and I am going to go into, XKey's own app, XKey Plus, that will update the app if it's plugged in via USB. They also have an XKey Piano, but I'm gonna go the hard way and go through something like GarageBand. Here's a song that I opened the other day to just record with this and play with this, and I can delete the track that's already there. There we go. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to the wrench. I'm going to scroll down and you'll see advanced and a list of Bluetooth MIDI devices, and nothing shows up because nothing's connected yet. If you notice, I've already connected once. Didn't have to do anything special, just shows up. It's there offline, but when I press the power button, it turns on, instantly identifies itself, and all I have to do is touch that and it connects. Now if I have my volume up, I need to make sure that I have my volume up, I can go in here, and right now I'm just recording an 8-measure segment. Got a little extra part there, but I'm just recording 8 measures. You can hit record. And volume. can even hear the pitch bend in that. Now, as another example, just going into Notion, and I was working here the other day as well. Since the keyboard is already connected in Notion, I don't have to connect it again. But I can select all these measures, and I can just delete those, and I can start over. And again, with Notion, you have to tell it what kind of note you want to play in. I'm going to do a quarter note. You can change it to a half note. So again, a super portable way to bring a keyboard with you, and very, very, very light, and it looks like it belongs with an Apple product. Take a look at that aluminum finish and how it compares. I mean, it's pretty amazing. So very highly recommended. The price point might be a little higher than you're hoping for, but again, you're getting a Bluetooth MIDI keyboard. And really my only gripe is that it doesn't come with a light bag to throw it in as you put in your backpack. Now, I think it's rugged enough to withstand being thrown in your backpack, but hey, why not? Why not do something like that? So that's the CME XKey Air, and I'm really impressed. Now, there is one other thing I want to show you with it, and it's connected with this, the WIDI bud. I'll show you that. And this was included by the company. And originally my thought was, oh boy, a wireless Bluetooth MIDI dongle. And I wasn't too excited about it. And that was kind of foolish on my part, because a little bit of reading further says, WIDI Bud is compatible with Windows, Android, macOS, iOS, Linux, and Chrome. So if you have an older iPad that won't run or connect to a Bluetooth MIDI device, such as the Jamstick Plus, the Puck, or the XKey Air, you could actually use a dongle and connect wirelessly with this device. Furthermore, you can take a Chromebook and you can make that into a Bluetooth MIDI device. So let's do that. I am going to go into my iPad and I'm going to disconnect this device. So again, you go to Advanced and I'm going to go up to Bluetooth MIDI devices and I'm going to disconnect that. And now it's no longer connected. Now I'm going to take this WIDI Bud out of the package. I've done this already, but give me a second. It's just one of those little plastic tabs. I figured it's a good way not to lose it, because it is very small. If I have any gripe about this product, it is the size of the product, which of course it has to be, so it isn't sticking out and gets broken off. So that just gets plugged right into your USB port, and there's a little light that flashes. And then on the top, there's another light. And when it turns solid, as it did now, it is now receiving data from that keyboard. So let's go to something like NoteFlight. NoteFlight is the best example. This flat IO will also allow it. And what I can do is I can go into one of my scores. And then, this isn't going to be a perfect example, because you do have to become a premium member to record audio in NoteFlight. But you can at least hear what's going on the Chromebook. So you need to purchase premium in order to use the MIDI keyboard. But with that little dongle, I now make this Chromebook into a portable MIDI device. Now, I can also show you that with flat IO. Can here's the test I was working on the other day. I was just playing into it. Now, this application is different because it starts off with a quarter note. So if you want to do something else, you actually have to change what you're doing. So let me actually, I'm just going to start a new score. That's what I'm going to do. It's going to make that easier. Create a new public score. I'm going to call this CME2. Just going to add piano for now. Create that score. Regular time signature. Start to compose. And again, flat will already fill in for you 4 quarter notes per measure, and it will expand as it needs to. It says MIDI output is disabled, but you can see where that little cursor is. And again, if I go up here to setups, right now it's connected through something called the WIDI Bud MIDI 1. So I can, in the place of these quarter rests, play individual notes, or I can play chords. But if I want something like a half note, I have to change that in advance to make that happen. And if I want to switch to something like an eighth note, I have to change that in advance too. And then there you go. So again, using a MIDI keyboard also. Go to Soundtrap, which is basically GarageBand for Chromebook, or as close as you're going to get. I'm going to open one of my products, or one of my songs, in the studio. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a new track. Gonna add piano and keyboards. Right now it's set to Rhodes, but I'm gonna choose something else. There's rock organ. And then I can hit record. And then when I hit stop and go back to the beginning, you'll be able to hear that. So again, a great way to get Bluetooth MIDI to your device. Now, as long as this is connected, this thing is going to know that it is with this particular device. So if I want to plug in a different device, what I have to do is I have to remove this dongle, just kind of take it out. I should turn this one off, like that. And now that I've unplugged it, it's not going to remember what I had plugged into it. So here's what I'm going to do as another test. I'm going to put that dongle back in, like that. And I'm going to pull out my old XKey LPK25, which connects via USB. And here's what I'm going to use. I'm going to use Zivix Puck. And again, this is a MIDI device that turns MIDI into Bluetooth MIDI. And you can either use a traditional MIDI cord, which this keyboard doesn't use, or USB. And they include this little Y dongle in there. So I plug in the Y dongle like this. Make sure it's facing the right direction, because it's always good. That's the one wonderful part about Lightning, is you remember about direction. Then USB cable gets plugged in. And then I power up the Puck, which runs on AA batteries. I had some problems in the setup, so what I had to do is to make sure that everything was connected right. So what I have here is my old LPK25 with the older, larger USB cable, connected to the Puck by Zivix, which connects via either MIDI or USB, and they send you to this dongle. So what that WIDI bud now is doing is it's automatically, it just connected by itself. Again, there's nothing to set up, nothing to do there. It's set up from the puck to this little connector. And again, if you want this WIDI bud to recognize a different instrument, you have to pull it out and plug it back in, and then it will do so. And just to prove it, again, you've already heard me playing it, but for example, here's that note. I actually have to go back to the right input here, though, I believe. There we go. Now I should be able to play into this chord right here. There you go. And again, so another way of making an existing keyboard into a wireless keyboard is a puck sold by Zivix going to the WIDI bud. Pretty awesome thing to do. Or again, if you have an older device that doesn't have wireless MIDI, such as my older MacBook, you could have a wireless connection then to your Jamstick or any other Bluetooth MIDI device that's out there. Now, I should also say, just in closing, I had two of the Miselu C24 keyboards that popped up. I was always worried about their durability. They were really neat, and I still check eBay occasionally to see if there's any that are selling for cheap to replace the two that I lost in Nashville at NAFME. This device completely outperforms the Miselu in just quality. And you don't have to worry, this is something that you don't have to worry about breaking. Now, granted, you don't want to throw it across the room, and no musician in their right mind would do so, but all the movement of that C24 and the smaller keys that were really the same size as the LPK for all intents and purposes just gives you a better experience. And you know what? You don't miss that travel of that keyboard very much. And truthfully, most people are not going to be performing on this device. This is a device for mobile recording, working with notation, doing some other things. This isn't going to replace the grand piano in your performance area, or the live piano, or the larger keyboard you have in your studio, but it's definitely a fantastic tool. And again, $199 for the 25 key, $299 for the 37 key, and I am not sure about the price of the WIDI Bud. WIDI Bud, made by CME. The website for that is www.widibud.com, and then the XKey Air by CME. This one is a 25 key module. If you're interested about anything else that's shown in this video, I would also point out that I've shown you the Puck by Zivix. I've showed you the Jamstick Plus by Zivix right there. And the only other device that I haven't really talked about, other than, you know what the iPad is, this is my Asus Chromebook Flip that again flips in half give you a tablet experience, kind of, with Chromebook. In closing, with devices like this, with the ability of NoteFlight and FlatIO and Soundtrap to use MIDI devices now through USB, to use the new Web MIDI standard, is changing the effectiveness of the Chromebook. Now, is the Chromebook going to give you an experience in music that the iPad can? The answer is no. Is the Chromebook going to give you an experience that a Mac-based MIDI lab for a music technology class is going to give you? The answer is no. But right now, you could use NoteFlight, you could use FlatIO, and you could use Soundtrap to teach both a music theory class and sort of a music technology / music productions class. However, you would need to buy subscriptions to those applications in order for your class to use those in a classroom setting. Thank you so much for your time. Thanks for watching the video. And please send an email if you have any questions about these devices or would like any help.